Hello everyone, welcome to MSSoft Webcast. In this video guide, we are going to perform a bare metal recovery backup of Windows Server 2019 Active Directory. So the question is, what is bare metal recovery? Bare metal recovery option allows you to recover your server from a hardware failure to a machine running on the same or different hardware. It requires Windows Server installation media to start the recovery process. Selecting this option automatically includes system state, system reserved, and critical volume that are necessary for the operating system to run. So for this video guide, I'm using my test environment created in VirtualBox, so you guys can have an idea about the steps to perform bare metal recovery backup of Server 2019. The procedure will be same on physical server as well. For this demo, we have our test lab with single domain Active Directory forest named mylib.local with two Windows Server 2019 domain controllers. This is our first DC, WS2K19-DC01 with the IP address 172.18.72.5, and this is our second DC, WS2K19-DC02 with the IP address 172.18.72.6. In the last two video demonstrations, we have seen the steps for system state backup and restore procedure. And in this video, we'll use our DC02 to create bare metal recovery image. It is highly recommended to use dedicated hard disk to store recovery image rather than using a shared folder. So let's open disk management first. Let's right click on start button and select disk management. Because for this demonstration, I have attached one hard disk. Let's select disk 1, and as you can see, disk 1 and disk 0. We have a two disk. On disk 0, we have our operating system, Windows Server 2019 on a C drive. And we are going to use the disk 1 of 100 GB to store our bare metal recovery image. Let's close disk management console. And one more thing which I want to mention, that if you have any partition created on the disk which you are going to use to store recovery image, will be formatted during the process. So make sure that you don't store other data on the disk. And as you can see, on our disk 1, we don't have any partition created on it. We have 100 GB unallocated space on our disk 1. Let's minimize the disk management console. So enough talking, let's start the first step in which we are going to install a Windows Server Backup tool on our DC02. For that, we need to click on Manage and select Add Roles and Features. On Before You Begin screen, you need to click on Next button. It is a feature-based installation, so we need to select role-based or feature-based installation. Click on Next. And we are going to install Windows Server Backup tool on our DC02 that is selected by default. Let's click on Next. Next again. And on Select Feature screen, you need to scroll to the end where you will find a Windows Server Backup. Select Windows Server Backup and click on Next. Now click on Install to start the installation. There are lots of third-party tools available for this task, but we are going to use the Windows Server Backup feature to do the job for us. Okay, as you can see, installation completed successfully on our DC02. Let's click on Close to close this console. Now let's open Windows Server Backup console. For that, we need to click on Tools, and from here you can select Windows Server Backup. You can also open the same console by using wbadmin.msc command. Now let's click on local backup. And here you can see no backup has been configured for the server, so let's configure one. I'm going to click on backup schedule. Click on next on getting started wizard. Now here we have an option that select the backup configuration. What you want to backup? Your full server or the custom one? See, by default full server is selected and it is recommended. Here you can see one line is there. I want to backup all my server data, applications and system state. But for this demonstration, we're going to select custom. Click on next. Now here we need to select that what we want to backup. And for that, we need to click on add items. Now in the last video demonstration, when we were backing up our DC01, that time we have selected a system state. But this time we are going with bare metal recovery. And that's why I'm going to select this checkbox. And once we select this checkbox, let me again cancel it and let's click on add items. If you select bare metal recovery, that time automatically system state, system reserved and C drive will be selected. Let's again see it let's select bare metal recovery. And once we select it, as you can see, system state is also going to be a part of BMI recovery. Fine. Now, suppose if you have any other partition on your server, because we have only one partition, which is C drive. Suppose if you have a multiple partition, that time it's up to you that do you want to include in this bare metal recovery or not. But generally, we are not going to include the partition on which we have other data. Let's click on OK. Fine, so bare metal, system state, C drive and system reserve partition is selected. One more thing which we need to configure is, let's click on advanced settings and click on VSS settings. Here we need to select VSS full backup. Why we need to select this? Because we are not using any third party applications to backup our server. That's why we need to select a VSS full backup. Let's click on OK. Let's click on next. On this console, you have two options to specify when you want to run this backup. By default, selected options is once a day and second one is more than once a day. So, suppose if you want your backup to perform automatically on particular time interval, that time you can select the time from this console. And suppose if you want to run your backup multiple times on a day, that time you can select the second box. But for this demonstration, we are creating bare metal recovery image, and that's why I'm going to select once a day. And I'm not going to change time because later on, by using this schedule, we want to perform backup manually. Let's click on next. Now here, the most important thing is there on this console, specify destination type. That will be a question that why we are not using backup once option to create bare metal recovery image and why we are using backup schedule. The reason behind this is, I don't know why, but if we select backup once option, then we don't have the option to select the hard disk to store the recovery image. Instead of, we can store that image on the partition, and that I don't want. And that's why we are using backup schedule. I'll show you that later on, that what exactly the problem is there. If you are creating bare metal recovery image, that time do not store that image on a share folder or on a partition. Use a dedicated hard disk to store your bare metal recovery image. So here we are going to select backup to a hard disk that is dedicated for the backup and which is highly recommended. Let's click on next. Now here you can see we don't have any disk under available disk. So for that we need to click on show all available disk. And here we need to select our disk 1. Here you can see the number is there, which is we have seen on disk management console. Fine. Let's minimize it. Let's click on OK. And now I'm going to select our disk 1. Fine. Let's click on next. It will give you a warning that when you finish this wizard, the selected disk will be reformatted and all the existing volume and the data on the disk will be deleted. Earlier, I mentioned you that do not create partition on the disk. Do not store any data on that disk. Let's click on yes to continue. Fine. So now everything we have set up, you are about to create a following backup schedule. Backup times 9 p.m. Advanced options we have specified VSS full backup. We are storing a backup on our disk. And the backup items are bare metal recovery, local C drive, system reserve and system state. Let's click on finish to create it. Fine, you have successfully created the backup schedule. Now let's click on close. Now let me show the disk management first. You can see our disk has been formatted and with the NTFS file system, and we have one label, as you can see, WS2K19-disk1 is there. Fine, so let's minimize it. So this is the location where we are going to store our backup. Let's minimize it. So you can also see your backup schedule on task scheduler as well. Let me show that. Let's click on tools and open task scheduler. Let's expand task scheduler library, under expand Microsoft, under expand Windows. And here we have a backup and our task is there. Let's maximize the console so you can see it properly. You can see Microsoft Windows backup. Right now we are not going to discuss about this task. We'll create a separate video on how to create and configure Windows Server backup schedules. Let me close this console and let's go back to our Windows Server backup console. Now we have successfully created the backup schedule for bare metal recovery image, but we don't want to perform that backup automatically. We want to create bare metal system recovery image manually. And for that, I'm going to click on backup once options. And now we are going to use that backup schedule, which we have created using backup schedule options. So you need to select schedule backup options. Click on next. And here the schedule is there, which we have configured, and that backup information is there. That is the bare metal recovery. Let's click on backup. Definitely the backup process is going to take some time to complete, and that's why I'm going to pause this video. Once the backup complete, I'll again resume the video. Okay, fine. Our backup has been completed successfully. You can see the status. It is telling us that it is completed. And total data transferred is 9.47 GB. Let's click on close to close this console. Now one thing will be there on your screen. Here you can see under description, we can see a fail is there. Now why we have a failure? The reason is pretty simple one. Because we have configured backup schedule, and instead of going with that scheduling, we have performed the manual backup. And that's why we are seeing this entry of backup is failed. Fine. Now earlier I told you about that why I am not choosing option backup once. Let me show why. Let's click on backup once. I'm going to select different option this time. We're going to select custom. Click on add items. Let's select bare metal. Advanced settings. VSS full backup. Next. Now this is the problem with this option. Here we can see we have total two options. One is that you can choose your local partitions, means your local drives, or you can store this backup on a remote share folder. I don't know why, but if we selected backup once options, then we don't have option to select the hard disk to store the recovery image. Instead of, we can store that image on a partition, or we can store that image on a remote share folder. And that's why initially we have configured backup schedule, and then we use that schedule to perform the backup manually. Let's click on cancel, and let me show that where our backup is stored. So let's open Windows File Explorer. Now on File Explorer, by default, you are not able to see that drive, because on that drive, we have our bare metal recovery image. So if you want to see, then you have to assign the drive letter to that partition, and then after you are able to see under File Explorer. Let's right click on disk one, and let's assign a drive letter to our partition. Temporary, I'm going to assign drive letter E. Let's click on OK. And now we can see that drive on a File Explorer. Let's open it. Here we have a Windows image backup. Let's double click on. Our server name is there. WS2K19-DC02. And this is the backup. If you open this folder, here you will only see .vhdx files. Fine, let me show that as well. Let's click on View. Select Options. And click on View. Clear the checkbox, hide extensions for known file type. Okay. Now here you can see we have a 2 VHDX image. This is the 440 MB VHDX image of our system reserve partition. And the second which we have is this VHDX image of our C drive. And that we are able to see in a backup image. So simply we can say, by default, backups in Windows Server 2019 are not encrypted. Primary, it is a .vhdx files that you can mount inside your disk management. Once after assigning a drive letter, you can access that VHDX just like a normal hard disk in your file manager. Let me close everything. And one more thing which I'm going to do, let's remove the drive letter which we have assigned to a BMR recovery image. Fine. Let's close this console and this console as well. So that's it for now. We have successfully created bare metal recovery image of our Windows Server 2019 domain controller named WS2K19-DC02. In the next video, we will see the steps to restore Windows Server 2019 using this bare metal recovery image. Thank you all for watching this video. If you have any questions, suggestions related to this video, feel free to post in comment section. Thank you all for watching this video.